sickly. I want it all now. I've been running through the pussy, need a dog now. 100 models getting faded in a dog now.
We're back here with Gilbert Young's Art World. We're here at Daddy's Designer Toys CEO Matt Williams' house. We're going to be viewing an exclusive collection of toys. He's a master toy collector, and he's got some pretty unique pieces, some rare stuff. We're going to see if we can make a deal. Matt, are you here?
Come on in, man.
Hate to give away your secret lair. How you doing, bro?
Not bad. Welcome to the art studio, the art gallery, whatever you want to call it.
This is Matt Williams' private collection. He's the CEO of Daddy's Designer Toys, and he also has a pretty popular Facebook group.
Kid Robot, vinyl art, street art, buy, sell, trade on YouTube, on Facebook.
Check it out, guys.
Daddy's Designer Toys on Facebook, on YouTube.
Shit. Yeah. They're probably on both.
Oh, yeah. Everything's under Daddy's Designer Toys.
Pretty exclusive collection here. He's got...
All over the place. It's just what makes you happy. That's what we like to collect. And then this is what me and my kids do for fun. We like to make our own art.
So these are all original pieces here?
Yeah, I'm a believer in using your imagination. And I feel like kids get stuck in phones and all nowadays. So I give them some paint and some markers. That'll get a kid distracted.
Yeah.
And it uses their imagination.
I notice they're all on canvases.
Yeah, you know, it just feels a little more fun. I don't think any of them will be any studios or nothing anytime soon, but, you know, the kids love looking at them.
This is your son and daughter's pieces?
Yeah, MJ did this one here. That's one of his favorites. I think Serenity did this one.
Wow. I like this dragon here.
Yeah, that's what she calls it, is a dragon. Yeah, and, of course, MJ's the rainbow. But you even look at the fridge.
And how old are your kids?
Five and six, I'm sorry. Sissy just turned five on the 23rd. But, you know, we draw. You look at my fridge, there's pictures everywhere. I have stacks of pictures that they paint or draw or whatever. It's just how we celebrate around here or how we have fun. Hopefully there's some good inspiration. We've got a lot of artists.
This is the Ron English wall, huh?
Very good, Ron English. Fortunate enough to meet the man. Well, this isn't Ron English. This is actually the guy who does Sesame Street art. Guy Gilchrist is his name. Everything else, Ron English. This was fortunate enough to meet Ron at a gallery he did in New Orleans, and I got this amazing doodle that he did. Huge, huge, huge.
What's the story behind this piece?
Ron was doing a gallery opening at the Red Truck Gallery that used to be in New Orleans. I drove all the way over there, of course, for the opening night. Ron was there and told him what a fan I was, and he was just so awesome that he doodled me a little picture in a notebook that I had. And of course,
that's pretty amazing.
I started into all this art because of the toys. I'm a product of the 80s, you know. As a kid, we played with action figures and stuff, so... When I started getting older, this kind of brought me back to my youth a little, and then through the designer toys, I got into the art. And, you know, there's even this piece right here is on acid blotter paper. So this was a release from Bicycle Day, which is what the day that they celebrate acid on, because the guy who invented it would ride his motorcycle around. But this is acid blotter paper. So if you look at it, it's a whole bunch of sheets.
Wow.
You can make your own acid out of it.
Spread it around.
But it's also numbered of 150 prints, so we're really
That's
not
going to
tear that up. Yeah, there's
pretty
not
rare.
Many of them out
it's
there.
It's a pretty rare wall here, the Ron English wall.
Good stuff.
This is a one of one. This is an original piece here.
Yeah, that one's the only one of one. The rest of them are, you know, limited runs and all that.
How much did you sell that one for?
Oh, I don't think that one's going to be for sale. That one, my kids will have to sell it. They'd probably give it to you for a 20 bag. You know how kids are.
20 bag of what?
I don't know.
It's pretty nice here.
Here we've got some...
Get some better lighting, though.
Oh, I got some lights here. We've got these are all by Shepard, Fairey, the Obey guy. If you ever see people with the hats and shirts that say Obey, he actually started as a graffiti artist doing guerrilla graffiti, meaning he just put the same image over a million places as he traveled around the country in his van, and basically just became famous through recognition. People would see this symbol and be like, what is that? And that's how he became a famous artist. Well, I mean, you know, hard work, but literally by just putting up so many of the image that people had to notice it. They talk about Coca-Cola and stuff like that, how Coca-Cola is subliminally planted in your mind through being painted on buildings and billboards, and you don't even realize you're being marketed to just in driving down the road. So why not have some marketing of something beautiful? This is a Banksy from his walled off hotel in Jerusalem that he did as a some focus over there for raising money for Israel and Jerusalem and getting attention brought to the wall that divides the people over there. Great print, simple, but as with Banksy, it always says so much. We've got Michael Reeder down here. He's also the guy who did the one over there.
It's pretty good, man. It's pretty good. I think
this is another Banksy. This is probably my best framed Banksy right here.
What is this?
This is what's called the Banksy Peckham Rock. It's really just a simple little piece of wood, but it's got, you know, the little detail on who he is on the back. Tells you the whole story.
Wow.
One of Banksy's earliest gimmicks was placing his own art in a museum in London. He literally took a piece of cement, drew this on there, and stuck it on a wall. I don't think they noticed for like 3 weeks that they had a piece of art in their gallery that wasn't even supposed to be there. And, you know, just one of the many great Banksy tricks or gimmicks or whatever you want to call it. But this was a puzzle me and my daughter did. We glued it together and made her a nice picture out of it.
That's good.
Because she loves Jack.
That's pretty good.
Of course, my off-white IKEA rug. Off-white Virgil Abloh, the designer. Used to work and design shoes for Kanye West until Kanye had a falling out with him.
Didn't he pass away recently?
I don't know. I hope not.
He might be dead, man.
Have to check into that.
That's pretty good.
Lots of books. I've even had books sent to me. Same thing I was telling you about the artist. This was sent to me by Roston Meyer. He makes his own art books, and this one's actually on a pop-up art book. And this is on the history of marijuana, or marijuana facts and stuff like that. So this was just a great little art book. Pop-up.
That's a cool book.
Isn't that awesome?
Wow.
Sent to me. All the famous people.
Elaborate.
It's cool. You know, I just like stuff that grabs my attention. That's all.
You got a lot of rare items here, man.
This is the Obey wall. These are a couple Banksys and Michael Reeder. Oh, there's a Banksy book. You'll see those in a lot of pop culture.
We got a Banksy book, guys.
That's a legit one, too.
I know you've probably never seen it.
If they're real or not, you can weigh them. I think it's supposed to weigh 2.2 ounces if it's a real Banksy book.
2.2 ounces, Banksy book. Okay.
These are all Shepard Fairey. This is actually the first print I ever bought right here. That was the one that got it all started for me. My Forest is a Dick.
Wow.
By Shepard Fairey.
Look at that.
I like that one. Says a lot.
Okay. What about this piece? Tell us about this one.
Oh, this is a great little piece. So these are the Shepard Fairey Dunnies, the 8-inch and 3-inch. When these were released in 2005, each of the 8-inch came with one of two different prints, little mini prints. This is the Obey 94, and that one's the Mandala Obey, I believe, something like that. But this was inserted one in five cartons, and then this was in four of five, so they only did about 200. This was one of the hardest pieces I ever had in tracking down. But these all came together with the 8-inch Dunny. It came with one print, and I was able to get both prints. That took some work.
Pretty impressive.
You know, it's just finding something you like, and you know, it doesn't cost a ton of money. I mean, there's stuff in here that costs a few hundred bucks, but if I buy it, I buy it from the artist. Very few will I buy secondary market because of the markups, plus it doesn't really go to the artist's pocket.
Yeah.
So I feel like I don't know. I have to really want something to buy it off the secondary market. That's one of my favorites too, the Michael Reeder. This is a $1,000 print right here.
Wow.
again, this was one he did when COVID first started. He did a 48-hour period. Anybody that ordered for 48 hours, that was how many he was going to make. And he ended up selling 1,446 of them.
So nice.
That print I love.
You ever want to? You want to get rid of that one?
Nah, no.
You don't sell any of this stuff.
Nah, I love it too.
Maybe we can make a deal or something.
What would
you offer you a trade? I don't know. I know a lot of people with your integrity aren't as open to cash value, but a trade sounds like it could be lucrative.
It's not about money. For me, it's about sharing the love. Like, I give people art and stuff all the time.
Look at these things.
Tag's still on there.
You ever see Sesame Street with the crossed eyes?
K-A-W-S is the artist name. Cause. Brian Donnelly. He actually started as an artist on the show.
Through the fields of our pots, feelings part our ways, keeping us close but estranged now. Dreams holding us closer. Meadows of our youth. 107 days.
I'm gonna just tell how I even got this Banksy real quick. I guess it'll go with. So these Obey posters came with the 8-inch dunny. Like I said, I had to buy two different dunnies just to get the two posters that I wanted. Well, one of the dunnies I ended up paying $18 for because the guy had it listed really cheap on eBay, and I got it with a print for $18, but I just needed the print. So then when I bought another one, I had two of these, and I had a guy, this was about 5 years ago, who had this right here, and at the time, basically I traded him $18 worth of a dunny for this Banksy, which is worth a whole lot more than $18 now. All because I was trying to put a print collection together. So, wow. $18. And then, I know you're a Trump fan, so I figured I would show you my... I don't know if you know.
You got some Trump stuff? Is it signed by Trump?
Not Trump. It's signed by Ron English, the artist. But, you know, people question his hair, so of course when Ron English made this, he gave him a little comb
over. It's a toupee.
And then it signed, got Ron to sign it while I was in New Orleans, and he did the
he looks like an elephant.
It's called, you know, to incorporate the Republican Party.
I see.
It's called Trunkophant, I think.
Trunkophant. You got any other Trump stuff?
I don't think so. I got the prints.
What about those prints you were talking about?
Did we not see those? I'll show you those.
We didn't get to see those.
These are by the local artist, Craig Bromfield. I just love these so much. And there's two of them from each rally that Trump did in the local South. Craig, the artist, followed him and made basically a show banner for each one. So this is from the thank you tour after he was elected over in Mobile. And then
good picture.
A talking crow, you know, shoving crow down their throats, yeah, or whatever. And then this was before he got elected, when he was doing the, you know, little campaign circuit. This is definitely one of my favorites here.
Donnie!
November 26th, so...
Yeah, that's great, man.
A year before the election.
Those are limited edition pieces?
Oh, yeah. All of them, number 120 of 120.
Wow, 120 of those made.
What
year was that?
This one was from the year before. If he was elected in 2016, this would be from 2015.
You gotta get those.
It's got the date on there, right? No, just November.
You gotta get those laminated, bro.
Oh, I need to get them framed. Yeah. Not laminated. Zelensky, real quick.
Oh, God.
Ukrainian president. Yeah. That's a bad man.
He's tough.
I wish he was our
They're president. All tough, man. Them motherfuckers, you got athletes going back and fighting. Like, what? You think LeBron James is gonna pick up a gun, bro?
Nope. It was like a 57-year-old actress that did, when the war was first starting, she was doing a commentary, you know, training with an AK-47. She died like 3 days ago, getting bombed. But 57-year-old actress with a gun defending her country.
Yeah.
America? Yeah.
They don't care about their country.
Oh, I hate America. I'm moving to another country. This country's so terrible.
This country's terrible.
Yeah, go over to Ukraine and tell them how terrible of a country it is. So
Sorry, didn't mean to go there.
Yeah. All right, man. Careful, they're right behind you. So I'm going to Atlanta next week. I'm gonna bring back a lot of stuff. I got a lot of.
Your dad's got some amazing talent.
I got some prints at the house too. I'm trying to get rid of. All right. Let's see what we got. I don't know if I brought the. I don't know if I brought the lady on the bench.
So you don't get nothing sticky or nothing on.
Let me see what we brought today. A little something. All right, you gotta be careful, man. The lead's still wet. Oh, I did bring her in. Yeah, this is a...
hand done.
Yeah, be careful. Paper's still clear. We'll leave that layer of plastic on there.
Wow. That's, charcoal, or...?
Yeah, that was the charcoal sketch that was done in 2009.
Wow, that is a gorgeous picture.
It's actually done over a period of 2 weeks. I'm supposed to be getting it framed.
He's going to canvas, he just needs to stretch it, huh?
Yeah, I'm just needing to stretch it, put it in some glass. So, I had an offer on it last week, but the guy never came through. So.
Who's the girl, you know?
I don't know, I think she was influenced by seeing somebody at a bus stop, so.
So just random
person. Lady on the bench, yeah. It's a piece of, from a selection of private sketches that I found. Mm-hmm. But that's why it's not even signed, man.
Wow.
Yeah, I'll get it signed though if I can sell it, man.
Right.
I had it listed for a pretty big number, and I'm having trouble getting it, so.
Well, you know, art is subjective. You gotta stick to your price and the person, wait for the right person, you know. Yeah. That is a beautiful picture, it really is.
Yeah.
Definitely some great, great talent.
I got it posted too, so.
What's the other one you got over there?
The other one? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Might have to work a little something out.
Yeah, I was going to take it back home, but not home to my home, but back to Atlanta. Put it back in the warehouse and maybe trade it out with some other stuff.
Yeah, that is a beautiful piece.
Yeah, it's a little fragile, and the charcoal always spreads, so you gotta be real careful.
Yeah, that definitely needs to be. You need to get a portfolio for that.
Yeah, man, I found it in the garage actually, and I only put it in this plastic because I had it in a sleeve, but I was worried about humidity and stuff getting to it.
That's what I was gonna say. You want to be careful with moisture in the shed.
This is another one. So.
Also.
Yeah, it's another charcoal, man.
Done.
All hand done. This one's actually still sealed. I'm scared to take it out because it was so messy. You can see the image through there, through the plastic.
This is gorgeous.
Yeah,
this one's on canvas. You have a hard backing back there?
No, it's not on canvas. It's actually drawn on like a plexiboard kind of material.
Nice. I love when people use the different materials like that. Ooh, that one's a little sexy too.
Yeah, it was done in like a private class that my dad was teaching. And they were actually having models come in there. It's pretty good, man. All this stuff I just found laying around, you know.
That's amazing, bro.
This one's actually, I actually do have an offer on this one, so.
That's a nice picture.
Yeah.
Especially for being original stuff.
This one was done on, this was actually a movie project that he was working on. They had him illustrating the cover that was going to be on the movie box and the poster.
Wow.
And the movie actually never got made, so. He never even finished. This was it. This is as far as he got with it.
Wow.
I'm willing to let that one go.
The detail, like, he's so talented, those faces.
Yeah, you've been painting for a long time, you know?
Everything about it, the depth, the detail, the scale is amazing.
And he got most of this done in a few days, but it always takes weeks to perfect it, you know?
Right,
artist is never happy until it's exactly how they want it, so.
Yeah, you've got some amazing work here, man. You just got to find the right way to market it or whatever, get it to the right crowd. This stuff should have no problem at all. So,
yeah, I've gotten offers on most of our pieces, but it's got to be the right offer.
Right.
Especially when you're dealing with only originals, only rare pieces.
You're only getting one chance.
You only get one chance. Once it's gone, it's gone. You wake up tomorrow and it'll be three times the price, you know? So,
so what do I got to do to get some out of you? What would you be interested in?
I definitely want some of the Supreme stickers, not leaving without those. And I'm interested in this piece. I know you won't give up that Ron English original in there.
Yeah, I'm keeping the Ron English. I just feel like he'd be a little offended if I sold that one. But I'll be willing to let a
Banksy
for some originals.
$5,000 for the Ron English?
Well, I don't even think I would take $5,000 for it. I know that's terrible, but
I think
one day it might be worth a little more. That's just something I want to give to my kids, you know.
So I want that piece.
I'll let Banksy go.
At least two sleeves of these stickers. I know these are one-on-ones. I'll give you whatever you need. If you need cash on top of it, if we need to go back to the warehouse and make another trade, I'll give you whatever you need to get that done. I really like these ones.
Which ones?
These four.
Well, I can't let them all go.
I know how it is.
I'll let one from each artist, maybe. We'll figure it out.
And I want to get a couple of these pieces. I want to get a couple of your kids' stuff.
And those are the high-value ones.
Yeah, these are the ones I came for.
Well, of course, I would be honored. I mean, that is the greatest thing in the world, to think that you enjoy them enough that you would want to hang some in your home.
I love this piece.
I know my kids would be happy with it.
And I call this the dragon.
The dragon. And that's what they
And how old are they?
5 and 6.
Wow.
5 and 6.
That's good. Get them started early. Let them open their minds.
Yeah, man. Use that imagination. It ain't got to be perfect. It's just got to be, you know, you having a good time, relaxing.
That's right.
Enjoying time with each other.
All right, man. I'm going to run to the bathroom, and then I think we're going to make a deal.
We're going to make a deal. Awesome. Man, these really are some amazing prints, bro. I do not say that lightly.